What's good, everybody? For those of you guys who are new here, my name is Sydney Baker Green, and I have a question for you. When is the last time you were genuinely excited about a smartphone? Now, I want to preface all the contents of this video that these are just simply my opinions as a tech enthusiast, but these are some observations that I have made over time with respect to the industry. With the exception of really 5G that just came out last year, all of the smartphones have pretty much become the same. And that is a good thing for the end user because for the most part, I can say with confidence that overwhelmingly, as long as you're kind of going with a flagship device, it really doesn't matter too much what smartphone you get. A lot of it is just going to come down to personal preference, brand preference, or the ecosystem you may be buying into. However, I feel as an enthusiast that this has made the world of cell phones and the tech industry overall, which is a video for a different time, a little bit stagnant. I want to say that it's boring. Simply put, I think the flair is gone. And that leads me to another observation. We've gotten to the point with our smartphones where everything just works well now. We don't suffer from the problems of bad battery life overwhelmingly, horrible screens, horrible speakers, so on and so forth. They may make some little adjustments to a phone to get another microtransaction, like removing a port so you have to buy an extra accessory, but every piece of technology for the most part works the way it should. But back in the day, the problem with smartphones was is that they had a lot of gimmicks, but they didn't work well. So smartphone manufacturers chose to remove the gimmicks, but improve on the hardware, which to me has kind of left the industry unbalanced. And we're gonna get to that word gimmick in a second, because this is where the Red Media Machine 1 comes in. Now, do not get me wrong. I still think the smartphone is not worth the price that it came out at originally. And I do think that the implementation of a 3D camera and a 3D screen was not the best idea because of hardware limitations. Although the 3D camera is an awesome idea in theory with a 3D screen, this led to some problems with the display where you can actually see the individual dots of the display, making it feel less crisp overall. And I mean, you can see it with your bare eyes. And this feeling of individual pixels makes it simply feel like you have a lower resolution screen. And that hardware limitation made it really drop the ball with respect to the competition it was facing in the market. And the price tag that this phone came out at made it so that it really just didn't catch traction. Here's the thing we have to ask ourselves though. If this hardware limitation wasn't necessarily there, would the smartphone still have been as horrible? And maybe if it was priced a little bit more reasonably, might it have gained some traction? This brings me to the point that, you know, again, I acknowledge 3D cameras are just something that's probably not gonna happen overall. Like, there's just the hardware limitation. However, I like that this phone stands alone on its own. This phone is bold. This phone speaks for itself and it gives you something to talk about. The only reason we're talking about a phone made in 2016 is because recently, with the purchase of the Red Komodo, you could get, I think, $700 off of the price if you owned a Red Media Machine 1. So you could buy the smartphone right now for $300 and get a discount on the Red Komodo, or at least you could. I believe that's expired. But the Red Media Machine 1 has something that you would talk about. First of all, it's a smartphone made by a cinema camera company. And then it also has a 3D camera. Here's my point. Although the implementation of the 3D camera was absolutely horrible and could have been done better, or if not at all, it still gives you something to talk about on this phone. And this is like back in the days when HTC was still a big company. The Sprint HTC Evo was one of the more popular phones at the time on the Android side. And then they also came out with a 3D version, which suffered from many of the same things. I think back to the days of the Galaxy S3 and the Galaxy S4, around that 2012 time period, where manufacturers were focusing very hard on their software. You know, they would come out with these gimmicks where you could swipe your hand over the phone and it would answer the call, or you could hover your finger over the phone and you would get a notification pop up. Like, it would sense that your finger's there. Or the features where if you kept looking at the screen, the phone would stay awake. Now, some of these features are still there, but a lot of them are gone. And you know, throughout this pandemic and doing a lot of cooking and also talking to my friends a lot, I just thought, man, I miss the days when I would just swipe my hand over the phone and didn't have to clean the dough off my hands from the noodles I was making. So let's recap though. They got rid of the features because, you know, the phones were just horrible overall. I mean, they were good for their time, but they were plagued by bad battery life overwhelmingly for the time, and they were just plagued with other things, and the screens were nowhere near as impressive as they are now, I guess when we look back in retrospect. But now that dynamic has changed. The hardware is good. So here's the point to the whole video. I think manufacturers can take a note from the Media Machine One, despite the camera falling short in the hardware department, which is what happened. Because a lot of these phones are blank canvases that are already amazing, focus on some software features that would give you a reason to talk about the phone. Break away from the status quo. This phone is not the thinnest phone in the world, and its shape is unconventional, but yet it feels so good in the hand. I would not even put a case on this phone. I don't know if they make them, but I wouldn't do that. And arguably, you could say that this is being done with some phones, like the squeeze feature on HTC, but I'm not talking about something you try once and you get rid of it. I'm talking about something where you make it into an ecosystem where, at least if you think people aren't going to use these features, they are there, and most importantly, they're easy to be found, because that's what will happen with these smartphone manufacturers. They'll put a feature in the phone, but then it's hard to find, and then you have to ask yourself, if a feature is hard to find, is it really there? This was just a little quick tech idea that I had as an enthusiast, seeing some more innovation on the software aspect. As Apple said, they want to rethink the general idea of a smartphone. And perhaps since we are reaching sort of a plateau, the software aspect of all of these phones could be the way to go. But let me know what you think in the comments down below. Have you ever found yourself missing some of the features on some of the older phones back when, you know, the smartphone industry was just booming with innovation and the ideas were revolutionary, not evolutionary? Let me know in the comments down below. If you like this video, be sure to give me a big thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, turn on those post notifications if you have not. Be sure to follow me on my social media friends. The links are in the description down below, as well as the YouTube fam. Their links are also in the description down below. My beautiful people, if you guys are ever feeling uninspired, uncreative, or just want to give up on life, remember, every day, airplanes take off against the wind. Keep climbing, stay inspired, friends, and as always, stay fabulous. My name is Sydney Baker Green, and I will see you beautiful people next time. Peace out.